Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that they make you drunk. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the count. I find then I get low. Lift up. It ain't nothing to cut the up. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Crystal. Look, I played the game, I missed the shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not, for lexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not, paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like any. One of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the neck of the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors. I'm mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand. I drop my guts, the world is us. So what, who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who tryna battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a second. I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz. Nobody blocking big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game, I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Animosity was out inside of me, so I'm like a product of power.
Who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Denver Broncos and the Los Angeles Chargers. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. First carry for the former Tar Heel, Javonte Williams. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And this will go as a gain of seven as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game. But in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
Third play here, this opening drive as they're up against. There's a play fake as they set up to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. That's taken on the 25. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake, Kyle steps away to his left. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Michael Ojemudia. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted. But they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Brings up second and five at the Chargers' 28-yard line.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They'll run out of the gun here. Williams, 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on second.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
Fant, the tight end, and he will have a Broncos first down by about a yard. It's a gain of five on third and four. Now a first down carry. It's Williams, and he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They go play action here on first down. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
On second down, Williams. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Give him 3 yards on the run. Now they'll need to drop something good here on third and 13. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 11, and the return goes up to his own 17-yard line.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long, but you can bet this defense knows that as well, so they've got him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
They'll run for the first time with Travis Etienne. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
a gain of 2. Brings up 2nd and 8 at the 19-yard line.
To throw on 2nd down. Kyle escaping the pressure right. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. First down, Kyle. Right side complete to Butler.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Flush to his right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle. Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield, because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody cut. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same. But they want it to be, right? What they saw last.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. They'll come up now on a 2nd and long after the hold. They'll drop to throw. Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10, and he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line. And not the first quarter that he was hoping for. Now 2 interceptions thrown.
Well, the good ones, they find a way to compartmentalize, right? Put these behind them, have that short memory, but understand why they threw the 2 interceptions. They go on and usually play a pretty decent game. Other quarterbacks, they have a hard time getting past it and often put the ball up for grabs the rest of the ball game.
They'll start on the ground, ETN. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. This defense for the Broncos, they have certainly had their struggles to start the season, but they put it all together in getting that first victory a week ago.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
We're scoreless after 1. And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. on the counter, ETN. And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Kyle, eluding the pressure right. Got an open man here. It's KJ Hamler. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator. They showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL.
So not quite a 1st and goal just yet as they come up now 2nd and inches. Back to throw, Kyle. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. A great effort there. His 1st touchdown on the year as his guys are 1st onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right.
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And 2 picks thrown here in this 1st half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Good, sure, hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. They'll look to throw here. Left side here, that's the tight end, Fant.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Here's a throw out wide to Anderson. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That is caught. It's Williams. And he's brought to the ground with another 1st down at the Chargers 33.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a 1st down.
On 1st down, it's Williams. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the 1st half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
This pass finds its way to Williams, and he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 16. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. Oh, nice move. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. They'll get six on the play, and it's going to take us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Second and four. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
On third down, here's Williams. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. Now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. The field goal try forthcoming now for the Broncos. The kick by Carlson is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. And a touchback here as Walker will sit on this one. The Charger drive about to get going. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. Second and 10. And here's a quick throw to Hamler on the edge. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down.
Get you fouled, boy. I'm talking. You out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, reach me snap. way. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that boy Jenny. And ain't talking game. It's like everything look cut them jaw. They go insane, they wanna pitch. Ain't gon' get in the beef, I'ma just make them blitz. Round 4 deep in the sprinter. Hottest your girl, and she in my rental. We ain't hot cables, we ain't even have no tunnels. They change the tunnel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Christian Lou, red bottom, them I think I cut my feet. They talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all. Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my wife to stop. He don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low was at. It was me against the wall. I was out here running plays. Guess it paid off after all. 613, bad girl. Her hat just got a star. She got it stitching, I got it stitching. We won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1, I lost the cap. I'ma charge it to the game. 438 is not a game. It's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane. Put right back in his lane. I'ma set that pat when I get to Cali. Hope it gets sent back over. Rain in your range, ain't send no players. All I'm getting ran over. Don't spare mine, gon' spare yours. We're not doing this game over. Only been rapping for like 4 months. Now they play a time.
It was once just an idea until breaking ground in November of 2016, and now here it is in all its glory. Spectacular SoFi Stadium here in metropolitan Los Angeles.
Today we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Denver Broncos and the Los Angeles Chargers. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Play fake here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down. Off play action. Kyle. Quick slant to Hamler. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Looking to throw. Kyle going up top for Miller. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game as it brings up 4th down. So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. Taken in at the 22. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It takes a touchdown-saving tackle to bring him down as he goes 32 yards on the return. And it'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over 1st and 10. They run for the first time with Javonte Williams. Ooh, with a juke. And some good running out of the gates as he takes this up to the 33.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Now Williams. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Now a handoff. Here's Williams. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
On play action, they'll throw. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And this is going to be intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And the Chargers are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. So, CD, his very first pass of the afternoon intercepted.
And I know that's a major surprise for any quarterback because, look, let's face it, no one thinks about throwing interceptions. But think about all the warm-up that we saw, right? Every pass he threw wasn't a single interception because, oh, that's right, there were no defenders out there. A little bit different when there's live guys out there chasing the football.
First carry for the Clemson man, Travis Etienne. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. Gets a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chain.
And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 2. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And he is not going to get away. The rush was too strong, and this is going to wind up a safety. Well, we thought these two defenses, they might come to play. One has already come to play here, a safety for the opening points of the game.
Brandon, let's file this play away because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are, but let's face it, partner, they can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
Second and 6. No, scratch that. 2nd and 7. He'll look to throw. That is taken in by the tight end Fan. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. They'll run on first down. It's Williams, and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
Because his primary job is defending against the pass, you don't often see a cornerback making tackles in the backfield. But he's playing run all the way here.
So 3rd and 5, defensively expecting pass. They've got 6 DBs out there. He's got his tight end Fan, and he will have a Broncos first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 5.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up on first down. It's Williams, and he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, 2nd and right at 1 yard. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three.
58 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports.
Williams.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver.
Javonte Williams
with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front.
So the toss play effective, even down here near the goal line.
Yeah, and you're hoping the defense commits too many men to stop the run in the middle of the field and that your blockers can gain a little bit of an advantage. And when they do, foot race to the pylon, and this time, he had the speed to win that race.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Charger drive about to get going. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
Well, they've already allowed 3 sacks in this first half, now a holding penalty.
So I think drastic measures had to be taken, right? The regular way was not working. He was getting hit almost every snap, it felt like. They had to try and keep him upright.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. 56. Off the play fake, Kyle. Going deep this time for Miller. And that's caught inside the 35. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big gain that time for the Chargers. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Off play action. Kyle. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Michael O.J. Mutia. And the Broncos are going to get the football here at their own 23.
That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43.
And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Point after, right down the middle, and the lead is down to two. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 75 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll run it with Williams. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Here's a second and 7. He's going to air one out for Anderson, and that's caught inside the 35. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 31-yard line. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Start backs him up 5, first and 15. Following the penalty, it's Williams shedding through the defense. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Second and 7. They'll hand it off now, Williams. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 22. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. A give to Williams, running right. Brushing off defenders. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here, we do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. Williams, a beautiful fake, and he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there, puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
They'll try and run. This is Williams. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
He's already found the end zone once in this half, and they do a nice job there pushing him backwards and denied his bid for a second score.
Now from the 7, here's second and goal. Now a man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Williams. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Looking to throw. It's caught on the right side. Williams. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's fourth and goal.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. A field goal try forthcoming now for the Broncos. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. The kick by Carlson is good. So 3 points on the board. As easy a field goal as you're going to get, but I can see you shaking your head.
I love that peripheral vision of yours, partner, because to me, if it's the fourth quarter and you're up 6, I get it. But now, even if you run and don't get in, you're still setting them up to go a long field, 98, 99-yard drive. How do you look at your defense and not give them that opportunity?
The Charger drive about to get going as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go here before intermission. This is Butler making the catch. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. And they do finally get him, but he makes it all the way to the 6. Now, we know this offense has the potential to strike quickly, and they just bit off 2 huge plays on back-to-back snaps.
So on the other side of the ball, you've got to go Band of Brothers thought process. No one left behind, no pointing fingers, no accusations, because if you don't, those quick strikes we just saw, they become long-lasting.
And his kick is good, and that will cut the lead down to just 2. So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hole. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with 3.
Very short kick taken right at the 20. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just 1 play. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got 2nd and 3rd down to fall back on.
Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. So we come upon